Come, have a seat in the Skald circle and hear the tale of the Brownie, as told by Mynogan. Before we begin our tale, did you know that we release new stories for free every week on Wednesdays? Be certain to subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts, Google Play Music, Spotify, Podbean, or whatever your favorite podcast app is. That way, you'll never miss out when we release free bonus stories other days of the week. Never forget, visit thescaldcircle.com to stay up to date with all of our current happenings, and to also visit our story archive, sorted by origin and region. Now then, this begins the tale of the Brownie. The Scottish Brownie formed a class of being distinct in habit and disposition from the freakish and mischievous elves. He was meagre, shaggy, and wild in his appearance. Thus, Cleland, in his satire against the Highlanders, compared them to fauns or brownies, if you will, or satires come from Atlas Hill. In the daytime, he lurked in remote recesses of the old houses, which he delighted to haunt, and in the night, he employed himself in discharging any laborious task which he thought might be acceptable to the family to whose service he had devoted himself. But the Brownie does not drudge from hope of recompense. On the contrary, so delicate is his attachment that the offer of reward, but particularly food, infallibly occasions his disappearance forever. It is told of a Brownie who haunted a border family now extinct, that the lady having fallen unexpectedly ill, and the servant who was ordered to ride to Jedburgh for the sage femme, showing no great alertness in setting out, the familiar spirit slipped on the greatcoat of the lingering domestic, rode to town on the lad's best horse, and returned with the midwife and croup. During the short space of his absence, the Tweed, which they must necessarily ford, rose to a dangerous height. Brownie, who transported his charge with all the rapidity of the ghost lover of Lenore, was not to be stopped by the obstacle. He plunged in with the terrified old lady and landed her in safety where her services were wanted. Having put the horse into the stable, where it was afterwards found in a woeful plight, he proceeded to the room of the servant, whose duty he had discharged, and finding him just in the act of drawing on his boots, he administered him a most merciless drubbing with his own horsewhip. Such an important service excited the gratitude of the lad, who, understanding that the Brownie had been heard to express a wish to have a green coat, ordered a vestment of the colour to be made and left in his haunts. Brownie took away the green coat, but was never seen more. We may suppose that, tired of his domestic drudgery, he went into his new livery to join the fairies. The last Brownie known in Ettrick Forest resided in Bodsbeck, a wild and solitary spot near the head of Moffat Water, where he exercised his functions undisturbed, till the scrupulous devotion of an old lady induced her to hire him away, as it was termed, by placing in his haunt a porringer of milk and a piece of money. After receiving this hint to depart, he was heard the whole night to howl and cry, "Farewell, Sir Bonnie Bodsbeck," which he was compelled to abandon forever. And that is the tale of the Brownie. Thank you for listening to our story. If you enjoyed it, please take a look at our Patreon page to learn how you can earn great rewards while also supporting us. We appreciate even the smallest of contributions, as they allow us to continue to release new stories every week for free on Wednesdays. And it also allows us to provide bonus stories for your listening pleasure. Visit us at thescaldcircle.com to view our story archive, sorted by origin and region, and to stay up to date with all of our developments. Once again, thank you for listening to our story.